granting you control and the ability to animate parts of a 3D model. Shape keys are an invaluable part of your digital toolkits. Looking to streamline the process of their usage, creation, or maintenance? Then seek no further than the scripts shown here. The system of collections will be familiar to anyone who's used the outliner. With the click of this button, a folder is added to your list of shape keys, a folder to which you can store shape keys, or other folders inside of. The main draw of this collection system, aside from its ability to format your shape keys in a logical way, is their ability to be closed and opened, showing and hiding all their contents. Furthermore, moving a shape key within a folder limits its location to stay within that folder, while moving a folder moves all of that folder's contents along with it. This is what you'll get with the Shape Key Collections script. It's a small but helpful quality of life improvement, which no one should be without. However, if you're looking for something with more impact over what Blender can achieve, linger longer upon my words. The Master Shape Key script not only includes collections in its full version, but also adds many new features not previously possible with Blender's systems. The basic version of Master Shape Keys simply gives you the ability to assign shape keys a vertex group. You get the vertex groups you need shape keys for, in this case the left half and right half of the face, although it can have any number of vertex groups and works on any model. You start the name of the vertex group with SKM underscore in capital letters. Then you go down and click one of the shape keys you need split up. Here, under vertex group keys, you'll see a list of all the vertex groups with SKM at the start. Just tick or untick whichever you want. In this example, we'll tick both for the left and right and click Generate. A version is generated with vertex group set for the left side and right side of the face. If you have the full version of this script and have the root shape keys in folders, then the vertex group shape keys will be added to these folders. Clicking delete or regenerating the vertex keys will always put them back into the same place. You can add drivers or animate these just as normal shape keys, with the added bonus that if you need to change them, rather than going through the tedious process of changing both, or deleting one and then remaking the other, you simply change the root shape key they're based off, and click again to update it. Any animation or drivers you've added will also be preserved. Another feature not possible without this script. Moving on to the full version of the Master Shape Keys script, you'll find that although both previous scripts are included, it has more to it than just the vertex group shape keys or the collections. First of all, beneath the name of the shape key, you'll see an option called Sync Object, sync for synchronous. If you select an object with shape keys, you'll see an option appear called Sync Key beneath. Select one of the targeted object's shape keys and now, the shape key selected here will control the synchronous shape key targeted in the settings. If you have a shape key in one object, which also needs to trigger the shape key of another object, this is what you can use. Next, Combine allows you to put multiple shape keys into a single shape. It's similar to Create Shape Key from Mix, apart from you can exactly control from all shape keys what you want used. Clicking Generate will start the process. A list of all the viable shape keys will be displayed and will show in real time on the 3D model. You can then modify the sliders here until the mesh forms into the shape you wish. It works on any model, the human face is just the easiest example. When it reaches a state you like, give it a name and click Generate, and a new shape key is created. Before starting this process, you can adjust the range of the shape keys. In default Blender, the range is how far a shape key can morph. 1 is the default, but it can go up to 10. Put this value higher if you'd like more extreme options for your shape keys. Next, we have the merge keys. These allow you to attach shape keys to one another in a sequence. Here we have a cube with 3 shape keys. The first, sphere, morphs the cube into a sphere. The second to a pyramid, the third to a cylinder. If we add merge keys to this list and disable the lock editing button, more settings will appear. The second list contains shape keys. I'll add 2 entries to the list, select sphere in one and triangle in the other. Up in the merge key list, we'll call it shapes and click generate. This value slider here in the merge key list activates first the sphere shape key, and then the triangle shape in the sequence. I'll quickly add another merge key, call it all shapes, and add four keys to it, and link them to the cube, sphere, and cylinder shapes. Generate again, and the new merge key goes through a sequence of all three shapes before repeating one a second time, just as set out in the list. When you're done adding to and editing the merge keys, just click the button here again, and all you'll have to deal with is the list of merge keys itself. You can give a merge key a name, as well as a vertex group for it to belong to, but be sure to regenerate if you change anything. This value can also be animated as well as given a driver. It has the same functionality as any other shape key. Also, you'll see here again the sync object sync key system. It follows the same process of before, except integrated into the merge keys. The last thing to note is the additive setting. When the additive setting is disabled, each shape key that gets triggered in the sequence disables the previous shape key that was active. In other words, only one shape key is 100% on at a time. With additive enabled, however, shape keys are not shut off as the next shape key starts, meaning that when the merge key is fully on, all of its contained shape keys are at 100%. The last of these tools is straightforward enough. In the drop-down menu to the right of the list, there's a button that duplicates all enabled shape keys, the ones with this tick box checked, an all button to duplicate all of them, and a selected key to duplicate whichever is selected. These will be duplicated regardless of any drivers or animations or other outside influences. With the various scripts and their abilities explained, be on your way to take whichever best suits your heart's desire. Just to reiterate, the full version of the Master Shapekey script does include the collection script with it. No need to get both if the enhanced features of the full version take your fancy. The tools in both scripts can be used for more sophisticated motions, for easily generating and managing shape keys, and for redefining what's possible with shape keys inside of Blender. This, along with the other tools this script gives you, is built from the ground up to help you walk the path of modeling and animation. Don't let the aid it offers you go to waste. Reach out and grab it with all your might. Let it help you through on your journey. Long may it bring solace to thy crozzle.